about you, Foxy Lady.
Please do. Thank you. So today we are filming, for the first time, I think, a revamp on a project that we've already done. Fox's was one of our first tutorials. Did we do that at the mill, Milo? I think we did it at the mill.
Yes, I'm pretty sure I didn't exist.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You didn't exist.
Yeah.
So we definitely have to redo it, just on that principle alone.
Yes.
We also are including in the kit enough supplies to make two foxes, and there's some new materials in it. We have a lot more available to us than we had 3 years ago, 3 or 4 years ago. And hopefully I'm also a little bit better of a teacher by now. And
Maybe.
And anyway, we just feel like we have more to offer, and it's a really popular project, so we wanted to do a redo. So this is the new tutorial. There is a new supply pack that we'll be using, like I said, just some new materials. The techniques have not changed too much. I have a couple of new tools that we can use that I'll talk about as I go, but I'm really bringing them together in the same way that we did the first time. If you're just getting started, you're going to need a felting surface and felting needles. Other things that are helpful, we have a reference chart for foxes. It's fox on one side, wolf on the other. And it just gives some proportions, some guidelines. And I use a tool called the Zoli tool. I use it a little bit in this project. It's not essential for this project, but it is a really handy handy tool to have. And I also, not in the kit that I did this time around, was used our new product, Swax, on the nose. And again, doesn't have to have it, it's just a little detail, but you can use Swax on the nose to make it look shiny and, you know, give it that different texture than the rest of the furry project. So you have anything to add to this bounty of information before we get started?
Not yet, but I'll have lots to say once we get working.
Okay, so we should get working.
Yes.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
What's happening?
I was just noticing that my ring, my mood ring, matches our logo. So
fancy.
I'm feeling it, I guess. We're gonna have to pay attention as we go and see if it changes as I get hungry for lunch.
You're gonna feel it less and less.
I'm opening the supply pack. So beautifully packaged by Mary. Okay. Whiskers, I'm going to set those aside. I'm going to take everything out.
Be careful, those whiskers are easy to lose.
Whiskers are easy to lose. And since the supply pack makes two projects, I like to take my pieces. This is the core. We use a lot of cinnamon and off-white chunky core. And I'm just going to split them in half and make two piles. So one is my second fox pile, and one is my current fox pile. So you guys can watch me do this for a second. These are all the accent colors. And I'm just estimating. There's plenty of wool in here. For the most part, I'm splitting things. I think I just hit the camera, sorry. Lengthwise, not lengthwise. What do you call the opposite of lengthwise?
Short, in the middle.
Shortwise.
In half.
In half. This is the red fox pelt that we make in-house. Okay. So I need two wires, one short and one long for each project. I need a 22 gauge wire for each project. I need 3 pipe cleaners for each, and I'm just going to set the whiskers aside. Okay, we're going to start with our armature. So I'm going to start with the short wire. And I'm going to find the center. This wire is 17 inches. This is a little change from the first kit as well. I just made it a tiny bit bigger so that, you know, you have a little bit more ease of the project, just having a little bit more size to the face, basically. And then we're going to twist 3 inches for the head and neck. So you can use the Stabit, has 2-inch marks, or the Zoli tool has inch marks. And about half and half, head and neck. Then we're going to find the center of the second wire. This is going to become the back and hind legs. So just find the center and then open it up into a mountain. And then I put this, the peak of the mountain, right at the base of the neck twist. And then I want to twist these two wires together so that the long wire comes back around and points at me 2 times. So that's 1 time. And that's 2 times. And then I need to do the same thing to the other side. For some reason I twist with my right hand, so I'm going to turn this around so that I can twist in the same direction. 1 time, 2 times. So I point the short wires down, they're going to be the front legs, and the long wires back. And I make sure they line up. I can kind of shift the shoulders a little bit to make sure they line up. And then I'm going to bring them together and twist for 4 inches. The twist isn't 4 inches. The whole distance from the front leg to the end of the twist is 4 inches. So you leave this open space here and you twist until the fox's back is 4 inches. Like that. So now we have some really long legs because we haven't put the leg folds and feet onto them yet. Okay, so for the front legs, we want, I usually put just a backwards bend for the elbow, about 1 inch down, and then 2 inches from that, another bend that represents the wrist, I guess. And then with your pliers, you should have about 1 inch left of wire here. Yeah. From this little wrist. Bend the toe back. Make a little loop. Using not quite 1/2 inch of it to make the loop.
So I would have said that the fox is part of the cat family.
Really?
It looks kind of cat-like to me.
Mm-hmm.
But that is not the case.
Mm, yeah. They are very cat-like. They're very slinky.
But they're a member of the dog family,
yes.
According to the internet.
Yes, according to the internet. The wise, sage internet. So on the hind legs, we want a stifle or knee at 1 inch, and then a hock or the back of the foot at about 1.5 inches, 1.75 inches, something like this. So 1 inch and then 1.75 inches. And that leaves a little over 1.5 inches, or about 1.5 inches for the remaining of wire. Now, when you bend an armature, you're going to have wires that are slightly, end up slightly different. So, like, for example, on mine, this right wire is longer than the left. That's okay. I'm just going to bend a little bit more of this foot around and a little bit less of this one to hopefully end up getting my hind legs the same. Okay, and that's really the armature. We just need the pipe cleaner, and this is gonna make the tail. So what I wanna do with the 22 gauge is wrap in the same direction that my wire is twisted. So just I'm gonna start where this twist is and just follow it down the back.
She's left-handed, people.
Yeah. So right-handed might look like this. And then I like to make a nice long tail. So I fold it in half at about 4+ inches. I think technically, if you were to look it up, their tail is about the same length as their body. And if you'll remember, we made their body 4 inches. And I'm just gonna let it stick off the back, above the hind legs, not between the hind legs. And once we get this all wrapped with wool, it will all incorporate and look normal. And I'm just taking this extra and twisting it around here. I'm gonna cut this off. These are our new, possibly, Fiskars. They discontinued the ones that we did carry. That's why they look a little different. Okay, then I have 3 pieces of pipe cleaner, and the pipe cleaner covers this aluminum wire and lets it lets the wool wrap and stick. Oops. So one pipe cleaner, I'm gonna find the center, span across the shoulders, and wrap down each front leg. When you get to the toe, you simply want to fold the pipe cleaner over the tip of the toe so that the very last thing is pipe cleaner, not metal wire. That'll make it easier for you to wrap with wool. If you have a lot of pipe cleaner, maybe cut some off. You don't want to like have to wrap back up the leg. You just want enough to be able to fold over that toe tip. Same thing on the hind legs. Find the center, put it over the back, and then wrap down each leg.
There's not a lot of fox jokes.
Well.
Which is okay. There's fox other things.
Okay.
We've got proverbs, we've got idioms, we've got facts.
Fables.
Maybe.
Foxes have those. Are famous
there's
for
a lot of,
fables.
There's a lot of fox stuff out there. There's also a few fox pickup lines. You know, like I said, hey, foxy lady.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
There's some good ones.
It worked.
Yes.
I'm yours.
Girl, if you were a dinosaur, you'd be a foxosaurus. That's a good one.
That doesn't mean anything.
Oh my gosh, that's so funny. Do pickup lines really mean anything?
Do they mean anything? Okay, this last pipe cleaner, I'm just going to come up the body, which I don't even really have to do because that 22 gauge is there, and then up the neck, out to the tip of the nose, and I'm going to cut some of this extra off and just fold it back over the tip of the nose. We are ready for wool. Okay, first thing we want to do is wrap the legs in black. So I'm gonna take about a 4 or 5 inch piece, and I'm actually gonna split it into quarters because we wanna keep these legs nice and skinny. So to split it into quarters, I split it in half, and then I split each half. And see how I start in the middle and then work to each end? It gets less fuzzy that way. So now I have 4 strips. And I want to follow the direction of the pipe cleaner. And make a nice, smooth, tight wrap. And if I follow the direction of the pipe cleaner and work with it, it will kind of disappear. When you get to the bottom of the foot, to get the foot covered, it's a process of wrapping towards, you know, in the same direction that you've been going, and then you flip it around and come back. So I'm going to do one more wrap in the same angle and direction, and now I'm going to angle it back and come back just for a couple of wraps. And all this little fringe, if you've got too much, pull some off. How's that light look? Does it look okay?
I think it looks good. I'm gonna zoom in for
all this
one.
Little fringe, you just keep smoothing until it's gone. And if you wrap tightly and smoothly, you really don't even need to needle felt. All right, we'll do another one.
I got closer.
Okay. You should be working with your non-dominant hand holding the armature, your dominant hand doing the wrapping and wrapping away from you. All right, let me see if I can angle this. Now I'm gonna angle back so that it tightens down on that tip. And then this time I'm gonna use all this wool because it's not very much. So I just keep smoothing it around until it disappears. But it needs to be fringy in just a little bit. If you got a big chunk, you gotta pull some off. It takes practice, for sure. And even though the tops of the legs are gonna be red, it's just easier to wrap down the whole leg than to, you know, only put black. This one was a little short. I'm gonna end up putting a little more wool down there.
Do you know what a group of foxes is called?
Oh, I don't.
It's weird.
Is it really weird?
It is weird. There's two names.
Okay. I love these names.
It's either called a skulk, S-K-U-L-K, okay. Or a leash.
A leash, interesting, because they skulk a bit around. Who here? What I love about this project, too, is we got the black, and we're going to do white and chestnut, and like it looks like a primitive fox very quickly, So it's kind of fun, but then you have all these crazy details. So I want to get some wool on the body. Before I do, I want to find my off-white chunky core and take about a 4-inch piece, which is the width of your hand, and split it in half and then give it a good stretch. Just really stretch this out so it's long and skinny and not such a big chunk. I'm going to pull this little fuzzy bit off. And then I want to wrap the nose. So, you know, I'm not so worried about the back half of the head, but I'm going to wrap very tightly forward towards the front and then very tightly back. And I stretch and draft as I go. And I might not need this whole piece. But what I want is a good, I'm going to pull some of that off. It's just a nice foundation for the white part of the face when I go to do that. And I like to work from my ends in. It's easier to build that way. And then this other half of that piece, I'm going to wrap around the tip of the tail. So just start back an inch or two, come towards the tip. I just let some wool hang off of the tip because it's going to get so fluffy and fuzzy that it's okay for that to, like, that's how the tip gets covered. You just let some wool hang off the end there. All right, now I can get into the chestnut or the cinnamon core. And I want to work with nice, I'd say like six inch pieces, split in half lengthwise. Give it a stretch. I'm going to put one around the tail. So I'm just going to start at the base of the tail and work towards that off-white. Try and keep it consistent so I don't have bumps. And stab that a couple times. And put one around the body. So I'm going to work from just in front of the hind legs towards the chest. Probably just span this. I got that a little collapsed here. Where the chest starts to widen. Stop there. Take another 6-inch piece. Split it in half lengthwise. Now I'm going to do the figure eight or the X wrap on the chest, which we do on almost every animal we make. So I'll show you. This whole process is, you know, just building up wool around this armature. So I go around the body to get it going. And then as I come over this side, I want to come over the shoulder here, over this, where we twisted the wires together, and cross under to the opposite armpit. So I've made half an X. Now I need to go over the back, and now I'm going to come under the armpit and go over the shoulder. And so now I've started to cover this chest area. And the rest of it, I'm just going to take around the body. All right, I'm going to do that one more time. Actually, I'm not. That was pretty substantial. So I'm going to start at the base of the neck with this other half a 6-inch piece, wrap up, and then wrap the back half of the head. I don't want to go onto this white. I want to leave this so that when I make my face, that white part is just nice and skinny and ready to build on. All right, and I'm going to keep working with 6-inch pieces, split in half. I'm going to do the body again. This time I'm going to start just behind the chest and go back so that this gets a little bit built up. And I think I need another one on the tail. That looks better. Kind of like a cigar kind of thickness. All the cigars I smoke, I know these things.
You're at the end of a cold. Your voice sounds a little bit like you could be at a...
I know, cigar. Right? Right. And then I'm going to put another one on the tail. I want a nice, fluffy, full tail. It's still going to get a top coat, but this is kind of the foundation for
it.
I
don't know. It's practically done to me.
Isn't that cool? Like, the way it just... You can make a very primitive little fox just doing these simple techniques. All right, before I get too much else going on the body, I want to bring the legs together with the body. So I'm going to use the chestnut core and do a wrap that, you know, pulls the tops of the legs together to the body. So let's see, I need about more like a 4-inch piece again, split in half lengthwise. Give it a little tug, make sure it's nice and smooth and consistent. On the hind legs, I want to start, you know, anchor at the top. I want to wrap around the stifle and turn around and go back up. And the goal is to have a tapered shape. Don't go all the way down to the back of the foot. Stay about an inch away from that. So I'm going to hold it on the back. I'm gonna wrap a little bit loosely because I wanna be able to stab this flat. I don't want it to be a tight log. And I'm gonna angle back up, and that's where you get that taper there. And then I want this to stay nice and flat. So I wrapped a little wide and loose so that I could put it like this and really stab that flat. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Okay. Sometimes you want things to be tight and log-like and, you know, firm and skinny. And sometimes you can control the wool with your stabbing if you give it a little wiggle room. And then this fluff I'm just felting onto the body here. So I'll do that again.
I think you referred to this core as chestnut core. But
it's cinnamon.
People are looking for it.
Yeah.
It's called cinnamon.
Yeah, cinnamon. So really, I'm doing this one the opposite way. If I wanted to wrap it exactly the same way, I would hold it like this and do it with my right hand, which messes me up. You'll figure it out what works for you in terms of each side. Okay, now I'm staying far from that hock, and I'm gonna angle back up, and then here's where I want to stay loose, let this make the thigh nice and full, and return to the body.
So why do foxes have such a bad reputation? This isn't a joke, I'm actually asking, because I'm looking at my notes and everything is all...
You know what? I don't know.
Don't let the fox guard the hen house.
Oh, yeah. They definitely like chickens. We've lost some chickens to foxes, but I don't get mad about it because I feel like they need to eat. You know, they need to feed their babies. I think they're beautiful. They're one of my favorite animals.
If you're a chicken, probably not so much
right,
liking the fox.
Right. We'll do another 3 to 4 inch piece for the front legs, more like 3 inches. Split it in half lengthwise, stretch it out. And we're gonna do essentially the same thing, it's just less wool. So I'm holding it on the shoulder. I'm going down just past the elbow. I really want this drawn out, not too thick. So I'm drafting it out to keep it thin, and then come back up and return to the body. That was a little chunky for me. Usually stab down from the inside. The Fox and the Hound was one of the very first movies I saw. I cried.
It's
very why
bad
can't
reputation.
Why can't we all get along?
Yes, right.
They weren't allowed to be friends. It was like a Disney animal animated Romeo and Juliet. But they're both boys. You know what I mean? They weren't allowed to be friends because they were supposed to be enemies.
So this Albanian proverb.
Okay.
Again. Poor fox. You will catch the fox with cunning and the wolf with courage.
Oh. Interesting. Alright.
Wolves are probably cunning.
Are they?
Do they have more courage than a fox?
They just work differently. They work together.
Yes, that's another fact, that they hunt in packs,
yeah.
But foxes,
foxes
are solitary.
Foxes hunt alone, they are. Mm-hmm.
So they have to be more cunning,
right.
I guess.
And they exist in areas, you know, that aren't necessarily very wild. You know, they're a predator in an area that, you know, may have a lot of population, people and cars and
chickens.
Uh-huh. Okay, I think I need another piece on the neck and head before I am ready to call that ready to build. So I'm stretching out a half of a 4 or 5 inch piece. But there's just a lot of wrapping that, you know, they don't have a ton of shape. They're very tubular. So I'm going up the neck, and then the remainder, I'm going to try to keep it on the back of the head here. Really want to build the back of the head into this little, a thicker ball than the white part of the nose. So before we do a face or get in the details on the body, I want to get the color on the legs. I like to use, I put in the kit Natural Black. I like to use that on the legs. You might want to leave it solid black. Totally up to you. But whether you use Natural Black or solid black, you might do this next step. So what I like about the natural black is that I can take a thin, you know, a 4 inch thin strip of it, and I can let it blend in with this chest, this, you know, cinnamon color a little bit, kind of soften that difference. And then just very thin, I'm going to come down and wrap. And I might linger right where this knuckle would be, this wrist joint. Just do a little bit of back and forth to build that up. A tiny bit. You don't want a big chunk there, but they do sort of have a joint there. At this scale, we're not getting super detailed on the legs. You know, in terms of shapes and... and then I can put natural black on the foot, or I can put, I feel like it just needs a little bit more, and I'm going to use black. Basically, I'm just getting a little bit more around what would be his paw, you know. Just give it a little bit more substance. We did a bigger fox project as a class, and we used ghosts or tacos like we did in the hair. We did hair feet tutorial this, and we actually gave their foot, you know, more paw-like definition. But like I said, at this scale, you're going to kill yourself trying to get that detailed. Every size has its coordinating amount of detail. I'll go ahead and do the other side so you can see it again. Just keeping this natural black piece real thin. It's almost just like a layer. It's not, you know, you're not adding more shape, really. And when I get down to that wrist knuckle, I'll just let it build up there a little bit.
What do you call a fox who's had a few too many?
I don't know what.
Infoxicated.
I'm trying to think if I have any fox stories. I made Dave clean up roadkill once. Because it was like, it was this perfect fox on the side of the road, and I had a friend that did taxidermy, and I was like, ah. And I was on my way somewhere, and I saw it, and I called Dave. I'm like, there's a dead fox. And then it just lived in our freezer for like 6 months until we threw it away. Poor fox. Okay, same thing on the hind legs. This time I'm going to take a little bit more of a strip because I want to do a special wrap on the hock here. So I'm really going to define where that bend is at the back of the foot. And then I'm going to come down to it and do a figure eight in this corner, avoiding the point, but wrapping back here and then here. And that kind of builds up this little hock joint a little bit. And then I'm come down the foot. And I gotta stab this to keep it. Sorry, I know I'm probably not in a good camera angle position. There you go, little fox. And I could put more black on that foot if I want to. We'll do the other side. So I'm letting the fringe overlap with the brown. And then, all right, this sunlight is messing with my eyes. It's not messing with the camera, is it?
No.
Okay.
So the gray fox has retractable claws like a cat.
Wow, really? I didn't know that.
That's what I'm saying. It's cat dog.
Yeah.
It's like a cat dog.
That's crazy.
They're all slinky. They're cat-sized-ish. Large cat.
I wonder what kind of differences there are between the Arctic fox and the red fox or the gray fox. And what's that crazy fox with the super long legs? Have you seen that thing?
There's a fox with big ears.
What's that, the fennec?
Ooh, you know that.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the pickup lines. Call me a fennec fox because when you talk, I'm all ears. That's if you're like
animal nerdy. Yeah, right. It's just you say that to somebody and they're going to be like, what? Or they're going to be like, oh, you're my kindred animal spirit. I love animals. We should go out, Milo, and try some of these lines. See how they work. Okay, enough. Enough of that. Actually, no, we have one more thing to do. I want to get the top coat color onto the tops of the legs so that when I put my pelt on, ooh, there's a little purple going on in my ring right now. So that when I put my pelt on, it's gonna blend right into that. So I'm just gonna take a real thin piece and do what I call a awareness ribbon wrap. It just goes around and then angles back up. So this is a real thin glaze of top coat. I'll show you again. Find a nice thin piece. Because this is like tapered, so you're not gonna be able to wrap around it. It's gonna slip down. So you have to put it on, go around, and angle back up and just let the fringe blend. Did you zoom?
I did a little. Okay. After this, the legs are done?
Yes.
Crazy.
And we're gonna do the same thing to the hind legs. Working with about 3-inch piece on the thin side. wrap and angle back up. Now sometimes they're a little light in their inner thigh, so you could use a little bit of the gray, light gray that's in your kit. Sometimes you could even mix it together with off-white chunky core. So you've got this little salt and pepper mix here, and just put a little bit while you're here on the insides of the thighs. Because his belly's white, so it's kind of like a natural looking. Coat color change that they have there.
You're almost off the camera.
Sorry.
Oh, no, it's okay.
Put a little bit of this color that I mixed.
Do you know what male and female foxes are called?
Vixen and... I don't know. I'm trying to think of what
Vixen
the...
Vixen is female.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of what the male is.
It's weird.
It's weird? Maybe I don't know it.
It's called a dog fox.
Oh, I didn't know that. I did not know that then.
So a male gray fox is a dog fox with retractable cat claws.
Yeah. That was funny. Cool. That's looking good.